Hello everybody, it's so good to see you back on my YouTube channel, Engaging English. As you know, I am your English coach Siddhi, and in this video, I have given a detailed explanation on the poem A Photograph by Shirley Chaulson. This poem is a poet's tribute to her mother. This entire poem is woven around a photograph depicting poet's mother and her cousins on a seaside holiday. As you read this poem, you will understand that the poet is remembering the happy memories associated with her mother. Looking at an old photograph, the poem consists of three stanzas depicting three different phases of life. So, let us start with the stanza one. The first few lines of the stanza one are as follows. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went peddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands and she, the big girl, some 12 years or so. Students, look at the opening line of the poem. The cardboard shows me how it was. It tells us that the poet has found an old childhood photograph of a mother. The word cardboard here denotes a photograph which is pasted on a cardboard sheet. Photograph shows the poet's mother as a 12-year-old girl with two of her cousins enjoying a seaside holiday in their childhood days. The photo was obviously taken long before the poet was born. Hence, she seems very nostalgic when she sees the picture. All three girls seem to be enjoying and having a good time. Basically, feelings of fun and happiness are aroused in these lines. The next few lines of stanza 1 are as follows. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera. A sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born. And the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. The photograph shows that all three girls, that is poet's mother and her two cousins, stood still, motionless, and smiled at the camera when the uncle clicked their picture. The poet could not help but notice her mother's sweet face. The expression on their faces was that of happiness and enjoyment. But the sad thing is, the photograph was taken a long time ago, and now the years fled past. Her mother grew up. They all underwent changes, while the sea remained unchanged despite the passage of time. Students, the last two lines of this particular stanza are very important. And the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. When the poet says terribly transient feet, she refers to the ever-changing imprints of the feet left on the sea. The word terribly here means awfully. It is used as an intensifier to convey, to heighten the effect of the emotions conveyed by the poet to the readers. It refers to the ever-changing imprints of the feet left on the sea. The word transient means something which is very temporary, something that lasts for a very short time. The sea in the photograph is still the same. It has changed very less, while the poet's mother, her cousins underwent changes. The poet here has highlighted short-lived life of the mother in contrast to the eternality of nature. Now let us look at the second stanza. Some 20-30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. "See Betty and Dolly," she would say, "and look how they dressed us for the beach. The sea holiday was a past, mine is a laughter. Both thrive with the labored ease of loss." Dear students, the tone used in this stanza is that of both happiness and sadness. After about 20-30 years, the poet's mother would look at the photograph and laugh nostalgically, remembering the happy memories of her past life. She would comment on the dresses worn by her cousins Betty and Dolly. This indicates that she is amused to see how she looked when she was a youngster. Students, it is just like you know, you having a fun time watching your childhood photo album and commenting on the way you looked and the kind of dresses that you wore then. Similarly, here the poet mother, after 20-30 years, she is recalling the bygone days. The poet remembers how her mother would laugh and feel disappointed at the loss of her childhood days. This is the meaning of the line, both thrive with the labored ease of loss. Here the word both refers to the mother's laughter and the poet's memory of a mother who is no more. The use of opposite words in the given line, labored, which means something which is achieved with great effort, and ease, something that is achieved with great comfort. It refers to the loss of happy childhood days of the poet's mother and the poet losing her own mother. Thus, everything in life is temporary and gets distorted with time. Although poet feels the sense of loss that may never go away completely with time, she has come to terms with her mother's demise. Moments filled with sadness and sense of loss for a time that was happier but could not be relieved. Moving on to the third and the last stanza of the poem. Now she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. And of this circumstance, there's nothing to say at all. Its silence silences. The poet recalls that it is nearly 12 years since her mother passed away. It leaves her sad and yet at ease. She has no words to express her loss and pain. The painful silence of this circumstance, which refers to the death of the poet's mother, has left her speechless and she is consumed with grief. Poet's mother's death has left her silent and stunned, creating a deep void in her life. It leaves her in pain but with deep sense of acceptance. The photograph is silent and leaves her silent as well. Dear students, if you observe carefully, there is a thematic relation between previous lesson that we have learned, A Portrait of a Lady, and this poem. There are common themes such as theme of loss, theme of acceptance, theme of transience of life. This poem describes three stages in the passage of time. In the first stage, the photograph shows the happy childhood of the poet's mother enjoying the seaside holiday with her two cousins when she was 12 years old. The second stage takes us 20 or 30 years later. It shows happy moments of the poet with her mother. And in the third stage, the poet remembers her mother with a heavy heart. The photograph revives a nostalgic feeling in the poet. Dear students, now let's have a look at the figures of speech used in this poem. If you haven't watched my video on figures of speech, I will put the link in the description box below. Kindly watch the video. Let's start with the first one, alliteration. All of us know that alliteration is the use of same consonant sound at the beginning of each stressed syllable in a line of verse. For example, in the given poem, the following are the cases of alliteration. For example, stood still to smile, the consonant sound S is repeated. Terribly transient, the consonant sound T is repeated. Its silence silences, the consonant sound S is repeated. The next one is personification. Its silence silences is a clear case of personification because here the situation has been given the human quality of silence. Moving on to our next to the next figure of speech, and that is transferred epithet. Transient feet is a very good example of transferred epithet. It refers to the human feet, but it is used to describe the lack of permanence of human life, the short-lived state of human life. The adjective for one noun like life is transferred to another noun like feet. And the last figure of speech used in this poem is oxymoron. Labored ease. Here the word labored means with great difficulty and ease means comfortably. Both words have opposite meanings, but here they are clubbed together to describe the same entity of loss, labored ease of loss. Hence, this becomes a clear case of oxymoron.